This is Sandstorm.
Like I was mentioning, the icebreaker for today is we're going to give our special mothers in our lives, whoever's a mother figure, either to you or, you know, to people that you know or something like that, we're going to give them a special shout out today. So we're going to take this time. I'm going to let you go ahead and give all the shout outs to all your mothers and, you know, what have you.
So I've got, if you know me, I've actually got three moms. No, it's not like that. And no, they don't have a they all have a relationship with each other, but it's not a relationship like that. These are women that I grew up with, women who have raised me in different aspects of my life. Shout outs to my actual mom, Vanessa, my birth mother. Love her so much. She's showed me a lot. She for the most part raised me herself, with my dad doing some assistance and stuff, but mostly my mom. I've lived with my mom for my entire, well, not my entire life, but my entire childhood life. She's been a great grandmother, a great grandmother, not a great grandmother. My kids don't have kids. But she's been a wonderful mom. I tell everybody, you know, I have nine sisters, all of them not through her, but through my core sisters, I want to call them, like the sisters that I actually live with, and my brother. I have two sisters, an older sister, a younger sister, and then a younger brother. And all three of them are all adopted. I'm the only blood-born one. So she's done a whole lot with them. Love them to death. My second mom is the one who also carries my last name. My dad's first wife, Mama Phyllis, I call her. She's been an amazing woman. I just kind of found out, like, the past history with the past couple years, with, you know, that whole situation. And it just made me really appreciate her even more. She's such an amazing woman. It takes a lot to take on somebody else's child the way that she did. She, as a matter of fact, her son, he was my brother. Obviously, he was my brother, and he passed away when I was young. And to kind of commemorate that, kind of to bring that on, I actually named my son after him. So they both have the same name, and, you know, she's always been there to love me. She's always been there to, you know, birthday, Christmas, you know, all the time, taking care of me, just throwing me presents, even when she didn't have to. And my last mother in this trifecta is who I call Mama Hobson. If you guys have ever seen B. Foster on the channel, that's my brother. That's his mother. She was the strict one, but she, because we were friends, she's not, obviously not my, you know, he's not my blood-born brother, but because we were friends, she treated me like another son. She would take me places. We would all go places that you would think, like, most parents wouldn't really do. She's got one of the most memorable moments in my life, for a Christmas time, for a Christmas moment. And I'm still trying to make that happen with my family, and it's nearly impossible. It was a play. She literally took me to a play, and it's nearly impossible to get tickets for the play. You have to do it like 2 years ahead of time. That's how crazy it is. And she was able to do that for us. She showed me what success really looks like if you really try hard at it. she was kind of the stern. My mom was always nice and she could be stern, but Mama Hobson was always like the stern and like, you know, you're a black man, so you know, you have to present yourself and you have to act accordingly. And that really stuck with me. So yeah, those are my, oh, and I want to give an honorable mention to Vito's mom, because though she's not my mom, she's my aunt. So like, much shout outs to her too, because she was definitely in that group too. And like I said, she wasn't my mom, but she was definitely my aunt, and she would carry herself as such. Like you would definitely think she came like right out the womb with the rest of my mom's brothers and sisters, because she acted just like them. She's loved me just like an aunt would. Took care of me. Had me come down there and spend time with them. Like, and even when she was back up here in Michigan, just being around like their family, and being a part of their family and stuff like that. That's just something that you really don't see.
Right. So, okay. That's what's up. Well, let me get up to it. You know what I'm saying?
Wait, before I get myself in trouble. And shout outs to my wife. Yeah. Mother's Day. Yeah. I don't want to get in trouble. But shout outs to my wife. An amazing mother. She is one of a kind. She is, I would say a tad bit older than me. She's 46. She already had two kids of her own. And then we decided to have a daughter. So, you know, now she's 46. Baby Sandstorm is 9. So she's been able to carry that. She's done so much for her kids. And her kids are at a level that, like, I'm so proud of both of them. And that's not to say, like, her ex-husband and her just done such a well job of raising those kids. But you can see the love that they have for their mom, and even baby Sandstorm, they've grown into something exceptional. So yeah, big shout out to my wife, so I don't get in trouble. Okay, now you good.
yeah, I was about to say, man. I was waiting too. That's why I was like, okay. You know what I'm saying? I was waiting. I was like, is he just stopped. I was like, why did he stop? But the plan is to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it. Don't you know we love you, sweet. Dear mama.